To all, the last
Good
class,
afternoon.
yes, the last class we discussed about the causes of poverty, right? Then Gauri, can you say the major causes of poverty?
Colonial exploitation.
Debt trapped.
Economic inequality. Drawback of green revolution. And population growth,
right? These are some of the causes. Okay, again I'm repeating, these are some of the causes for poverty. These are not only the causes, these are some of the causes of poverty. And today we are going to discuss the major strategies adopted by the government for solving the problem of poverty. So the government strategies of poverty alleviation. The government strategies of poverty alleviation. The government strategies of poverty alleviation include two types of policies. One is promotion of economic growth, and the second one is anti-poverty programs. Okay, so the government strategy of poverty alleviation. The government strategy of poverty alleviation include two types of programs. One is the promotion of economic growth and the other is anti-poverty programs or poverty alleviation programs. First, we are going to discuss promotion of economic growth. Growth. Do you think that a country develops or a country grows, its poverty will reduce?
No.
A country is developing. Okay. When we can say that a country is developing? India is a developing country. America is a developed country. Right? How we are saying
yes,
that?
According to the facilities and...
Yes. According, one of the thing is the facilities provided in the countries. Then?
Economic growth.
Based on their growth. Based on their income, we are dividing the countries. So if a country is developing, suppose India is growing. It means what?
It is growing the economic, the growth means
you are growing, right? That means what?
Development.
Here, see children, think about yourself. Your date of birth may be in 2006. From 2006 to 2020, what growth that happened in you?
Now we have learned
height, weight, right. That is a growth happened in you. Then what are the developments happened in you? Your behavior is same in 2006 and 2020?
No, ma'am.
Almost, right? But in generally, when we are seeing according to your age, your character must change, right? You are mentally, physically, emotionally all developed, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no? If you are due to education, due to other facilities, physically also you changed, you are mentally, emotionally, all the things, a development happened in you. Same way for a country also. When a country is growing, its income is increasing. But when a country is developing, what are the changes happening in the country? China is developing fast. How we are saying that China is developing fast?
More production.
Very good. More production is happening in China, right? Their industries are growing fast. India is developing fast. How we can say that? More people are working in the service, different sectors. Their income is increasing the country. Maybe new industries are coming, or the agricultural development will be there. New companies, IT companies are there, or the field, doctors, engineers, IT professionals, transportation, communication, industrial development, agricultural development. So for all the field, if a country is growing, its income is increasing.
I can't see you, Alshi. I can't hear you.
Rest all of you, any problem?
No, ma'am.
No, dear, maybe network connectivity issue.
Now it's okay, ma'am.
Okay, so these are the problems. That means growth. Then how does growth help to reduce poverty? So suppose in the case of India, India's agriculture is developing, India's industries are developing, our service sector is developing. How this help to reduce the problem of poverty?
Ma'am, more jobs.
More jobs, right. Then any other answer?
If we are getting more jobs, then people don't have unemployment, so they could earn enough income to provide their needs.
So the first point is how poverty alleviation program, the first point is growth, right? Economic growth. Now you understood what you mean by economic growth. If the income is increasing, if country is developing, automatically it will be come down to the people. That is trickle down policy. That is a term we are using, trickle down, coming to the downward sections of the society. So if a new industry is coming, an example I will say for economic growth, a new industry is coming. If a new industry is there, it will create a lot of employment opportunities, right?
Yes, ma'am.
A new industry is there from the beginning itself for the construction of the industries. It get a lot of people will get job. Then after that, once the industry is set, again, so many people will be employed there. Then also, if an industry is there, near to that, some shops will be there. Road will be there. Transportation will be there. Communication will be there. So it helps to reduce poverty to a certain extent. That's the first policy or the strategy of poverty alleviation, that is stimulating economic growth. Nowadays, yesterday also our finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman, so press meet is there. Have you heard about it? At least in the newspapers, main heading is that. There also we are giving the growth stimulating policy. That means it's a policy, growth stimulating, giving so many packages for increasing the growth of the country. So one, the government strategy for poverty alleviation or employment generation, whatever it is, that is promotion of economic growth. Then how economic growth help to reduce poverty? You know that India is one of the fastest growing countries in the world. And the planning adopted for achieving quick economic growth and economic growth, as you said, if there is a growth, it will create what? More employment opportunities. So more employment opportunities means it will help to reduce the problem of poverty. So if there is an industry is coming, it will create more employment opportunities and it help to reduce. It will give the employment to the local people also who are living near to that area. So more employment opportunities and it will help to reduce the problem of poverty. That's the first policy. Remember the government strategies of poverty alleviation. The government strategies of poverty alleviation is divided into two. One is promotion of economic growth and the second is anti-poverty programs. So first we are discussing the promotion of economic growth. Promotion of economic growth. Promotion of economic growth means a country is developing or growing, it will create more employment opportunities. And if there is more employment opportunities means people are getting more employment. More employment means they all have enough income for them to meet their basic necessities. So it helped to reduce poverty. Again, so many videos are of why children? Every time, like a reminder you need, turn on the videos. Shania, Elsa, Sriram, what amended? Okay, that is the first one, promotion of economic growth. And the second is poverty alleviation programs include the anti-poverty programs. That include so many programs introduced by the government for creating employment. See, I have a doubt. How the employment creating programs leads to poverty reduction?
If people get job, they will have income. So they can be...
Yes, that's answer. So sometimes when you are hearing that poverty alleviation programs, almost all that programs are employment generation programs. Clear? All the poverty alleviation programs we are discussing are employment generation programs. So that time, don't be confused. Why poverty alleviation? We are studying this employment generation program. Only by creating more employment, we can reduce poverty. It is not practicable. It is not possible for a long time to give food items to every person for reducing poverty. So it's a permanent solution is create more employment opportunities. Okay. So the poverty, anti-poverty programs include, or the poverty alleviation programs include employment generating programs. So some programs are there. It is confusing. Before starting, I am saying it is confusing because so many programs we are studying here. So it is better to note it down. Don't depend on the textbook for this. It is better you must write it and keep it with you. And you write it in a paper and staple it in that textbook. Because so many programs, so many new names, new terms for you, and also each of the program is different. All the programs aim is to reduce poverty, but the year it is introduced is different. Its aim is different. Some is for creating employment among educated people, some for uneducated people. So many is there. So better to sit with a pen and a paper and note it down. First anti-poverty program is National Rural Employment Guarantees Act. National Rural Employment Guarantees Act. It is called as MGNREGA. The two programs are same. MG means Mahatma Gandhi. Okay. This is also called as NREGA or MGNREGA. That means Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act or National Rural Employment Guarantees Act. I think in the textbook it is given as NREGA, right?
It's given Mahatma Gandhi National.
Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, the same thing, okay. NREGA means... It's Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act. It is very, very, very important. Next year in your 10th standard also, you will study the same program. Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act. Have you heard about this program? Anyone? Thozhilurappu Paddhathi, you heard about it?
I think so.
That is NREGA. Okay, that is NREGA. That you heard about it, Thozhilurappu Paddhathi? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, the same project is MNREGA or NREGA. Under this scheme, they are doing that, okay? So, MGNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act. It was introduced or it was passed in which year? 2005. This program was passed in 2005 and it provides 100 days of employment. It's there to provide 100 days of employment to everyone in rural household in 200 districts. So it was initially introduced in 200 districts for providing 100 days of assured employment. That means it's a duty to provide a minimum of 100 days employment to the people. And initially it was introduced in how many districts? 200 districts in rural area. See children, first listen here before writing. Just listen to me. The program, the project is MGNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act 2005. Like that you must study, okay? Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act 2005. And as per this act, there should be an assured 100 days of employment. How many days? 100 days of employment. And it was introduced in how many villages? How many? 200 villages in the rural area. This project is for rural area. And if the government failed to provide 100 days of employment, what will do? They will get unemployment allowances. Okay, if the government failed to provide 100 days of employment, they will get unemployment allowances. And in this MGNREGA, another speciality is 1/3 of the job is reserved for women. In MNREGA, 1/3 of the job is reserved for women. That is the speciality of that program. That is one of the most important project for poverty alleviation or employment generation. That is MGNREGA. We are saying something. It is NREGS, NAREGA. NAREGA 2005. What is its full form? MGNREGA?
Mahatma Gandhi
National Rural Employment Guarantees Act. Year also 2005. Okay, how many days of employment will be providing?
100
days of employment. And if initially in how many villages this was introduced?
200
villages. And this is for which area, rural or urban area?
Rural.
Rural. Rural. Now the answer, it is for the rural area. And if the government failed to provide 100 days of employment, what it will give? If the government failed to provide 100 days of employment, it will give?
Unemployment
allowances. It will give unemployment allowances. If the government failed to provide 100 days of employment, it will give unemployment allowances. And another important speciality, what it is?
1/3 job for women.
1/3 job is reserved for women. For women. Clear, children? This is why I should repeating this many time, because next year also you want to study the same program. That time when the teacher asks, don't sit idle in the class, okay? that is MGNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi. If you are NAREGA 2005, NAREGA. Now we are adding Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act 2005. As per this act, 100 days of employment opportunities are creating for the people who are living in the rural area. Initially, it was introduced in 200 villages, and if the government failed to provide 100 days of employment, it will give unemployment allowances, and 1/3 of the jobs are reserved for women. Clear? Any doubt in this project program? For anyone want to repeat this? Yes or no?
No, ma'am.
Okay, the second one is National Food for Work Program. Second program is Food for Work Program. What do you mean by Food for Work? The term itself have the answer. Food for Work, what does it mean? Food for Work means what?
When people working for food.
Ah, yes. See children, in your home, but here means food for work program means instead of wages, what we are giving them?
Food.
Food.
Food grains. Not as a food, as food grains. Clear? That is food for work program. So the name itself have the answer, right? The name itself have the answer. So the National Food for Work Program, the National Food for Work Program, NFWP, Food for Work Program. It was launched in which year? 2004. The Food for Work Program was launched in 2004 in 150 backward districts. In 150 districts, unskilled workers are given employment and wages are paid in form of food grains. So here the job wages are paid in the form of food grains, and also the work employment is given for the unskilled workers, skilled and unskilled workers. For the unskilled workers, employment opportunities are providing, and in return their wages are paying in the form of food grains. So that program's answer is there in the question itself. That question, that program's answer is in the question itself. National Food for Work Program. Instead of work, what they are getting? Instead of wages, they are getting food grains. That is Food for Work Program. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So the two programs, one is Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act. It was passed in 2005 and provide 100 days of employment for the people who are in the rural area, and it was introduced in the 200 districts, in the rural households for the 200 districts. Initially it was introduced. Then another two specialties, 1/3 of the jobs are reserved for women. And if they fail to provide job, it will provide unemployment allowances. Then the next program is Food for Work Program. It was introduced around 150 districts, and it is introduced in 2004. And as per this program, the employment is providing for the unskilled workers, and their wages are paid in the form of food grains. Their wages are paid in the form of food grains. Clear? Next program is Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana. Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana. It was launched in 1993. And it aims at creating self-employment for unemployed youth in rural areas. See, this is what I said. Some program have a definite purpose. Here, Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana. What is the name of the children? I will give you time to write, okay? Please don't write now. I will give you time to write. Just listen here first. Listen here first. Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana. What is the name of the program?
Prime Minister's Rozgar.
Rozgar Yojana. That it is launched in 1993. It is launched in 1993. And what was the aim of that program? To create self-employment for educated unemployed youth. See, so this Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana is for creating employment opportunities among educated youth in rural area. Create employment opportunities among educated unemployed in rural area. Clear? So which program aim at providing employment for educated people in rural area? Which program?
Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana.
Prime Minister itself is an English term, right? Normally we are using Pradhan Mantri. Many of our projects are also like Pradhan Mantri. So Prime Minister, it is for whom? Educated. Compare like that. Prime Minister is for whom? Educated. Educated youth in where?
Rural area.
For the educated youth in rural area. Another program. Wait. Okay, if you want, you write it. That program. Don't write this, okay? So many programs, if you are writing together, it will be confusing to you. Finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So children, today we studied three programs, right? MGNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act 2005. Then after that, which one?
National Food for Work Program.
And after that?
PM Rozgar Yojana.
PM, Prime Minister Rozgar Yojana. So the Prime Minister Rozgar Yojana is for whom?
Educated unemployed youth in rural area.
Okay.